Hello, and welcome to this episode of the South Texas College Library Database Spotlight videos. For this episode, I will be going over a database that is not in our discovery search. This database is called Today's Science. I'm Anna, an academic outreach librarian here at South Texas College, and I will be your guide. Once you get to our library website, library.southtexascollege.edu, there are two different areas to access our databases. One is in the Discovery Search toolbox underneath Focus Search, and the other is on the left-hand side under Research Tools. I already know the database that I will be looking for, which is Today's Science. The great thing about Today's Science is that it features thousands of original articles written by scientists and science journalists, and it is also very straightforward and an easy website to follow. Almost everything is pretty laid out on the main page, but if you want a more linear approach to it, then you're able to look at these three lines on the top left corner of your screen. Okay, let's go down the list. We'll start with topics. Here you can browse different topics like anthropology, mathematics, all the way down to technology. As you can see on the left-hand side, you do have the subcategory showing, but if you check on the right-hand side and you just want to click the subject, it will take you to that area where you can see the subcategories. So here you have different articles pertaining to that subject. What I like about this is that you can save if you create a profile, share, cite. You can look at the standards. So if you come down, pick Texas, view standards, it does go through the standards that this would pertain to for each grade from 6th grade all the way to 12th grade. It reads it aloud, and you can turn off the glossary links if you'd like, or you can share it with Google Classroom. If you scroll down, you can see that this article does have pictures, but there are other articles that do have videos for the students as well. At the end of the articles, there are discussion questions, so you can bring these up with your students to start a classroom discussion. Okay, next on our list, we have conversations with scientists. These are first-person accounts of recent breakthroughs for that particular scientist. So you can actually filter by the topic, or if you already know the scientist's name, you can search through their name. Again, when you come here, you can save, cite, share it to Google Classroom, but when you scroll down, it's a little Q&A with that scientist about their research that they've been doing. Next on our list are research topics. So here, if you give these students a research paper to do and they have no idea where to start, they can come here and try to figure out a topic that they would like. Also, if they don't know how to do a research paper, on the right-hand side are more research tools. So they can come here and try to figure out how to do primary resources, what plagiarism is, how to evaluate online resources, or just how to write a paper in general. So there's a bunch of different articles there for them as well. So on the left-hand side, they can choose something that interests them, and they have different articles pertaining to that subject. Again, on the right-hand side, it did change, but it does give them more topics for them to look at just in case they're not finding what they want here. So once they click on the article, they can save, cite it, share it to Google Classroom. You can see that they have pictures here as well. But again, at the end of the article are discussion questions, so they can use those discussion questions to help them write their paper. So what I just noticed is that this particular article has a teacher's guide on it, and it is a Nobel Prize lesson that you can use in your classroom. So if you come here and check it out, look through all these things that they have here, you can use this in your classroom. So some articles have that. Awesome. All right, next is the video news briefs. Here you can see on top that they have featured video news briefs. On the bottom, if you know a title, you can search that way, or on the right, you can search by topic. What I've noticed is that all of these are tiny little videos that use real-world examples to help teach that topic. This would be great to use in your classroom so that the students are able to see where science and math are being used outside of school. Next are a lot more resources that you can use in your classroom or the students can use if they're trying to figure stuff out for their research project or if they're just interested in any of these topics. So, crossword puzzles. What I like about this is that you can still share it to Google Classroom, but the students are able to come in here and check out what they know. If they're able to figure it out, they can type in the word here. They can check their answer. If they still don't know it and they're not able to answer it, they can reveal the word. So now that they'll know for next time. Next is editorial cartoons and questions. There's a lot of stuff here for you to look at. What's great about this is that you can use this in your classroom to start a discussion. And if the discussion falls short, well, then it has discussion questions for you so it can help keep it going. There is a glossary that the students can use just in case they don't know what a word means. And then you have Year in Science. So these are huge articles for you to read that just discuss what happened in that year. Also, there are discussion questions at the bottom as well. Next is sources. This just gives you a list of the journals or magazines or newspapers that they received their information from. It doesn't take you to that area, it's just a list of it. And then finally, we have curriculum tools. So there are two different sections. You have it for students, where they can come and check out some stuff, and you have it for educators. As always, if you know the topic or subject that you're wanting to find, you can search for it on the top search bar. There's also an advanced search. But if you're doing dual credit and you need to know what TEKS to use, you can come here to browse standards. So this gives you the standards for science grade 12, like I had asked. But the cool thing about this is that if you want to do a specific standard, you can come here and find correlations to help you think of ideas that you can do in your classroom with the students. On a side note, I'm able to edit, so it might look like I received these TEKS quickly, but it actually took some time to load. Thank you for watching this episode of the Database Spotlight videos. I hope I was able to give you some good insight on the database today's science. So until next time, bye!